This tutorial will carry on where we were looking at adding windows and doors to the walls that we added in an earlier tutorial. From here, we're going to go to our elevations, and we're going to use our elevations to start adding additional levels for every floor and roof that we need in this project. With Revit, the default is to have two levels that are 10 feet apart. Those are never named first floor or anything like that, so you can always rename them. So you can either zoom in to the text itself, click on it, and then rename it. Typically for industry standard, everything is all caps for your text. So you want to make sure you do it that way. You'll also get this question, would you like to name corresponding views? And what that's asking about is for other things that we see over here in the project browser. So if we say yes, then our ceiling plans will also have their names changed. And then as we add other plans like structural plans, those things will be changed. At this point, it's fine to let them be renamed, but sometimes we don't want to do that. So always consider when you get this question and never check do not show me this message again, because then sometimes things will get renamed and you didn't realize it and you have to go back and change it. So I'm going to hit yes. And you notice again that the first floor plans changed, as well as the first floor ceiling plans. So what I'm going to do next is, instead of clicking on the text, which sometimes can click on other things like this little zigzag, which allows us to start manipulating the level marker, I'm actually going to come over here and click on the level 2 text and right click, and it allows me to rename it that way. Here I'm going to name it second floor. So now I'm going to zoom out, and what I want to do is add a third level. So we're staying in the Architecture tab, but if we come all the way over to the right, you notice that there's the level symbol. So we click on that level symbol, and the best thing to do is to hover over the end of one of the existing levels, and you notice that a little dotted line helps align them, and you can either try to get to a certain height, and you notice the measurement over to the side, or you can adjust it later. You notice it's also trying to snap to the top of that wall, and remember the default when we started making those walls was 20 feet, so that would actually get us to another 10 feet. Either way you want to do it, you can always adjust it later. I'm going to click, and then I'm going to bring the tool all the way over to this side, and again it will link to the others, which is important because you may want to move them, and when you move them or adjust them, it adjusts the others at the same time. I'll show you that in a minute. So now I have this third level. I want to hit escape twice to get out of the tool, as I do with any of our tools, and now I want to rename my level 3. For this project, this is a two-story house, so the third level is going to be my roof. Roofs are actually quite complex, so just because I name it roof right now doesn't mean it wouldn't change to something like bottom of roof, top of roof. I might add more levels as I go. And for those of you that have multiple stories, you want to add all the levels that you need before you keep going too much further. So let's just add another level. And I will rename this top of roof, which you will start to see in some drawings because that helps with structural elements like the structure of rafters, the structure of trusses that you use, even for things like material locations. Sometimes you'll also see TOR for top of roof. Okay, so one great benefit of having these level markers is now we can click on one of the walls, and I'm actually going to show you this in 3D so that we can click on the walls a little more easily. I'm going to click on a wall, and now over here in the properties, you notice that our base constraint is our first floor because that's the lowest level of our building right now. I can have a base offset where I can put a minus and go below, or I can just put 3 feet and it will raise it 3 feet above the first floor. And then here you notice the top constraint is unconnected. That's again a Revit default when you start a new project, but I want to change that to be roof. And when I hit apply, or I wait a few seconds, it then brings it up to the roof. But you remember, I made the roof 20 feet. So if I go back to my east elevation and I change the height of my roof, which I can do here in multiple ways. I can use the arrow tool and just move it up and down. I can zoom into the actual text for 20 feet and change that, or I can use this measurement tool and I can make it 12 feet. Revit always defaults to feet, so I can just type in 12 and it will make it 12 feet. So keep that in mind, because if you want it to be inches, you have to put in the actual inch symbol or it will default to feet. You notice that that changed that roof level to 22 feet instead of 20 feet, and that one wall that we made connected to the roof level as opposed to unconnected like the other walls adjusted with it. There are pros and cons that go with that. The pros are, if you need to adjust your whole building, you can adjust your level. If you need to just adjust one thing, then you need to make sure you do that. You also notice that the other level did not move because we have the height set. It's not in relation to the other level. So now I can go through and I can click on all of those walls and I can make the upper level that roof. And that's something ideally we want to do before we go too far in our drawing, but it's something that we can do in any way that you're comfortable with. I want to make sure to save. And so another benefit of those elevation markers being moved is that we can place windows and doors in relation to that. We can place windows and doors in elevation or in plan. I can copy them. So I can take this window. You notice when I selected it, the Modify Windows tool opened up, and I can now go over here to this tool. Instead of just moving it, I can copy it. And I can copy it from one level marker up to the next. And you notice when I click on it, the windows themselves have got information about where the head height is, meaning the top of the window, where the sill height is, which is the bottom of the window, and I can change that. So I can make the sill height on this 2 feet so that it will lower it, and hit apply or wait a second, and then you notice that that changed the head height from 9 feet to 8 feet. That's part of construction, the head and the sill, and those are things we'll learn about in this class. So when we're using the elevation markers, it's something that's really important that we make sure that we use and we adjust them accordingly based on our project. Next, we're going to learn about other elements within the project so that you can set up your elevations and other things.